إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر الحديث. We praise and glorify the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the wonderful opportunity in these blessed days of the month of Dhul Hijjah to witness another Jum'ah. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the permission, for the ability to obey His command and establish the Jum'ah prayer. It is from the mercy of Allah. It is only from the kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're able to obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us special times in the year where we recognize and observe special occasions, special events. In these blessed days, the season of Hajj and the month of Dhul Hijjah, we heard a lot about the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. We heard a lot about the life and the sacrifices made by his family. It is only fitting that we take certain lessons as we go through these days, as we finish the season of Hajj that we've just completed, that we reflect upon what lessons we could take from the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam and how we can apply them to our lives. As Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the command to submit to His will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given each and every one of us that command, that you have to submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be a Muslim. When we look at the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself declared Ibrahim alayhi salam as the embodiment, the true practicing Muslim. Which means that we now have to compare our lives to the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam if we wish to be true Muslims. One of the very few people in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared as a Muslim, that his actions portrayed the actions of a Muslim, was Ibrahim alayhi salam. When him and his son, in Surah Safat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when him and his son, Ibrahim alayhi salam, when they submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they forgot about their own desires, their own objections, their own issues with the command, and they just submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at that moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, now they are practicing Islam. So this is what it means to be Muslim. And you and I, if we wish to call ourselves Muslims, then we have to come close. We have to at least draw a comparison between our lives and the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family. What he was willing to sacrifice, what he was willing to give, was the ultimate sacrifice. Ask a father, he would rather give his own life before harm coming to his child. Ask a father, he will tell you, I'd rather harm come to me than to my child. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam that you yourself must be the cause of harm coming to your child, you sacrifice your child, your only child at the time, this was the ultimate sacrifice. And even at that moment, Ibrahim alayhi salam was a human being. He was like you and I. He had the instincts of a father. He had the protective nature of a father. He had a wife, a mother, who also, after convincing from her husband, Ibrahim alayhi salam, after telling her that this is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she also submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A son, a young child, who also understood, because of the household that he was brought up in, he understood that we have to obey the command of Allah above everything else. So father, mother, son, as a family, they came together and they obeyed and they submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They practiced Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word Islam to describe their action. Aslama wa tallahu lil jabeen. When they both practiced Islam, and he turned him on his forehead. That is the moment when Ibrahim alayhi salam took his son and he was about to sacrifice him. The scholars of the tafsir explained that he turned him on his forehead because it was too painful for him to look directly at the face of Ismail alayhi salam. He was about to sacrifice his son, so it was too painful for him to look at him directly. So he turned him over, so his forehead was on the ground. At that moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, now they have just practiced Islam. That was the definition. That is what is required of you and I. Of course, Allah doesn't give us the command to sacrifice our children. We don't have to sacrifice our lives, our family's lives. But we have to be willing to do that much for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what Islam requires of us. We have to be willing to obey the command of Allah when it comes, regardless of what excuse we have, regardless of what tiredness we feel, regardless of what inconvenience it would bring upon us. We have to be willing to submit wholly, completely, wholeheartedly, without objection to the command and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say we Muslims, people who practice Islam. Muslim, the person who practice submission to the will of Allah. But are we willing to? Is it coming from within? And this was the beauty of the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. He taught us, and it doesn't become more glaring, more obvious than living today in this time, this age, how important and how genuine the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam was. He wasn't one who did things for show. He wasn't one who was worried about the optics. He wasn't one who was concerned about what others thought about him. He went against the practice and the belief, the customary practices of his entire family, his entire neighborhood, his village. They expelled him, they tried to kill him, they tried to burn him. He went against the tide because he believed in the greater truth. Ibrahim alayhi salam showed us that it doesn't matter what anyone thinks. It doesn't matter what others perceive. What matters is your connection, your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He practiced Islam from within. Ibrahim alayhi salam practiced Islam from within. His relationship with Allah was a spiritual one. Today, unfortunately, our relationship with Allah is very superficial. We focus more on the optics, on the social media aspect, what we can show, what others perceive. And we judge and we like to be judged based on what others can see. But when it comes down to the moments that matters, when those tests come before us, the simple tests, like leaving our beds and getting up for Salatul Fajr, when no one is around to observe our actions, when the cameras have gone and the public is asleep, and we are there with the command of Allah in front of us and our weakness and our temptation in front of us. What is our choice then? What sacrifice are we willing to make then? How much do we submit to Allah at that moment? The world was against Ibrahim alayhi salam. Everyone he knew turned against him. His own father said, لَأَرُجُمَنَّكَ I will stone you to death if you continue speaking about believing in one God. And what did he do? He stood steadfast. He remained steadfast on the truth. He didn't worry about how many people approved of his actions. He didn't worry how it would look. This was the command of Allah, and this is what he did. Every moment of his life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested his resilience. We were not given big tests like Ibrahim alayhi salam. We're not tested where our parents tell us that they're going to kill us if we continue worshipping Allah. We're not tested where after waiting 100 years to have a child. His first wife was barren, she couldn't have a child. After waiting many years, according to the scholars of tafsir, he was about 100 plus years at the time when Ismail alayhi salam was born. After waiting that long and then receiving a child, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then commands him, not at the same moment, This is how difficult the test was. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waited until the child grew up. He grew a little bit. And he was in a playful age. According to the scholars of Tafsir, he was at that age where he would run around with his father. Very close bond was being formed between father and son. He would play. He would have that relationship and talk to his father. And at that age, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, now the test would be greatest. And test after test came the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he showed that his Islam, his submission to Allah was real. And what is the reward? What did he receive for this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, A'udhu billahi min shaitan ar-rajim, وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. When Ibrahim alayhi salam, when his Lord tested him over and over and over, فَأَتَمَّهُنْ, and Ibrahim alayhi salam completed and passed every one of the tests. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now I will make you a leader for mankind. Ibrahim alayhi salam is an individual that every major faith of the world today recognize as a sacred person, as a noble individual. Any religion, any Jew, Christian or Muslim will tell you, Ibrahim alayhi salam is held with great reverence, great honor and respect in that religion. Allah made him a leader, a pillar for mankind, for humanity. This is what happens when we go through the difficulties. When we persevere and we go through the challenges that Allah Azza wa Jal places in front of us. The big challenges and the small challenges. The temptations and the addictions and the weaknesses. When we go through it. When we leave it for the sake of Allah. When we forsake our desires and we place the will of Allah, the command of Allah ahead of everything else. When we do so, not only from within ourselves, but we teach our families as well. Do you think if Ibrahim alayhi salam had only focused on his own upliftment, his own Islam, his own self-reformation, and not taught it to his family, to his wife, to his child, they would be willing to practice Islam the moment Allah's command came? No. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, from the beginning, he taught his family that the priority, the most important aspect of our life is to obey the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From leaving his neighborhood, the area that he was familiar with, and taking his family and leaving them in the desert. At that moment when his wife asked him, is this the command of Allah? Why are you doing this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us Ibrahim alayhi salam left his family. His heart is heavy. He's concerned for them. His wife is looking around. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the area. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the area where he left his family. Newborn child, young mother. He left them there. On the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it went against his logic as a father, as a human being. There is no food here, there is no shelter, but Allah's command is to place them there. What is this? What is this quality that is coming out from Ibrahim alayhi salam here? From his family? This, my dear brothers and sisters, is called tawakkul ala Allah. To place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That it might not make sense to me at the moment. I don't see the logic. But my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me this command. This is the command of Allah. This is what Allah is pleased with. And I will do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I put my trust that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward me. Allah will provide for me. Allah will take care of my needs. Because I am obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam left his family. He turns away and he's walking. His heart is heavy. He's a father. He's a wife, he's a husband. He left his wife. He turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he says, Oh Allah, Rabbi inni askantu min dhurriyyati biwad. He said, Oh Allah, I have left my family in the valley. Biwadin khayri dhi zara. not a single blade of grass is growing in that valley. He described the valley in his dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he was concerned about it. He said, "Oh Allah, there isn't a blade of grass growing there." But he did so to obey the command of Allah. Then he asked Allah, he said, "Oh Allah, liyuqimu salah, oh Allah, let them establish salah." He didn't say, "Oh Allah, send rain upon them. Oh Allah, send food for them." He said, "Oh Allah, let them establish salah." As parents, we're always concerned about the well-being of our children. As I said, we will give our lives and our well-being and our comfort for their happiness and their comfort. As a father, as men, we're concerned about the well-being and the welfare of our families. We're concerned about their safety. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he left his family, he made dua to Allah, "Oh Allah, let them establish salah." The first dua he made, "Oh Allah, let them establish prayer." Because he understood that if they established salah, then whether he was there or not, once they had that spiritual bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their needs would be taken care of. Their protection would be guaranteed. Because the salah that they would perform, the worship of Allah, would take them close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he understood that I am not there. Just like when we leave our families and we go to work, we go away, we travel, whatever. We're not there. But if they have that relationship with Allah, then wherever they are, whether you're there with them or not, like Ibrahim alayhi salam, he understood that if they had that bond with Allah, they established salah, they pleased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah would take care of their needs. Allah would protect them. So these are the things that we have to learn from the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. That when the time for Salat al-Fajr comes, and we love the child so dearly, we wake them up to perform the Salat. We stop them from whatever they're doing during the day and tell them to perform the Salat. We don't look at them lovingly and think, let them enjoy themselves. No, this isn't happiness. Happiness is when you see them obeying Allah. You see them making sacrifice to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That should bring you happiness. Look at Ibrahim alayhi salam. Every part of his life, whenever challenges were placed in front of him, his first priority was to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us take this lesson for ourselves and our families. Let us take this lesson and implement it in whatever way it can be applied to our lives. Whenever we're faced with that choice, with that challenge, with that difficulty, with something we have to sacrifice, let us remember that the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam was much greater. We might sacrifice our comfort, our tiredness, our temptation, our weakness, our time. But this is what is required to be a true Muslim. We cannot claim the title of Muslim. We cannot say we practice in Islam. And then when the command of Allah comes, and we're faced with a decision, and we're faced with a choice, we choose our own weakness and our own desires. Islam isn't about following our desires. Our nafs, our desires, is the opposite of being a good Muslim. Our desires, it is one of the things that we have to fight against to be a good Muslim, to practice Islam. Our desires would always tell us to do the easy option, to do the more enjoyable option, to take the easy route, to take a shortcut, enjoy the nap, eat the haram food, drink the alcohol, smoke the cigarette, look at the haram movies, engage in a haram relationship. This is our desires on one side. Islam, our submission to Allah, tells us, stay away from that which is haram. Submit to the will of Allah. Make the sacrifice. Control the desires. This is where we have to go. We know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the person is placed in his grave, a righteous person, a noble person, a pious Muslim, And when he's placed in his grave, the angels will come to him and they will question him. And then they will show him a spot, a place in the fire of Jahannam. This is a pious person. The angels will show him a place in the fire of Jahannam, a burning fire. He can feel the heat. And they will say to him, this was your place as well. However, Allah gave you two places in Jannah because of your sacrifices, because of your decisions to obey the command of Allah. You had your name written on a spot in the fire of Jahannam, and you had your name written on a spot in the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is for all of us. Every decision we make, every choice that we make, every desire that we follow takes us towards the fire of hell. Every sacrifice we make to obey the command of Allah takes us one step closer to our place in the paradise of Allah Azza wa Jal. The choice is ours. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in the hadith, حُجِبَتِ النَّارُ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ وَحُجِبَتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, that in this world, the fire of Jahannam is covered, is veiled, it is screened by our desires. Following the desires is what leads us to the fire of Jahannam. وَحُجِبَتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ, and the Jannah of Allah, the paradise of Allah, the things that we aspire to achieve on the day of Qiyamah, that blessing, it is covered by difficulties and sacrifice. The life of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the hallmark, the thing that defined him was his willingness to be steadfast in the face of sacrifices. We know about sacrifice at some level. We've just completed a year where Allah placed challenge after challenge in front of us. Us sitting here today is a testimony that we have persevered and come out ahead of that challenge. We have great resilience within us. Let us apply it to every aspect of our deen. Let us apply it to our family lives, our personal lives, our children's lives. Let us teach our entire families to prioritize the will of Allah, the command of Allah over everything else, in our presence and in our absence. Don't do it for us. Don't do it for your parents. Don't do it for your community. Don't do it for show. Don't do it for anyone to see. Rather, do it to strengthen your bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what matters. Young and old, male and female. On the day of Qiyamah, what would come to light? What would define where we go? What would determine our success or our failure? Isn't how many people consider us to be pious. Rather, it is the condition of our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah. When we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one is going to ask us how many people thought we were pious and righteous and noble. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal our records, and that is when the truth will come to light. So the small sacrifices and the big ones, the ones we make in private and the ones we make in public, let us do it all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us develop an attitude of conviction and willingness to sacrifice our desires, our comforts, our happiness for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wholeheartedly against our logic, against our desires. Let us be willing to put our trust in Allah, that, oh Allah, if you have given me this command, I will do so regardless of how I feel about it, regardless of what I think might be the outcome. Put our trust in Allah. Be like Ibrahim alayhi salam. Even our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was told that you are following the millah, the way, the millah to Ibrahim, the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam. If our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if he was commanded to follow the millah, the way of Ibrahim alayhi salam, then who are we to think that we are any better or any different? We have to be like Ibrahim alayhi salam. He's our role model. He's our guide in our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us forget about the superficial nature of the world that we live in today. Let us go back to being Muslims from within. People whose hearts are connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Forget about how you look on the outside. Forget about what people think you are or who people perceive you to be. Concern yourself with my relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What am I willing to do to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What am I willing to do to receive and to have that relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a simple thing, but it is a great thing as well. It is a simple thing, but it is a great thing as well. It is the only thing that matters when it comes to our spiritual well-being. What is our connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let us learn from the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam, so that we can become something close to what Ibrahim alayhi salam was, that we can implement his behavior, his practices, his attitude in our lives and in our families' lives as well. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. الآية، وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من شاهدين وشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة. اللهم اغفر لعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم، ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم. وخير القرون قرني، ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر. أقيموا الصلاة.